The next-gen iPhone CPU could be 500x more powerful than the Silk C in the first iPhone. The iPhone 17 Pro will keep up with Apple's dramatic rise in performance. PC Watch has done a new study that looks at how Apple's smartphone CPUs have changed over time. They determined that the iPhone CPU has gotten 384.9 times better since the first model came out in 2007. The study used Geekbench data to track performance over time and came up with an average annual improvement rate of about 40%. If things keep going this way, the next generation iPhone 17 Pro, which is slated to come out in late 2025, may bring that number above 500. Steve Jobs released the first iPhone in 2007. It had a Samsung ARM11-based Silk C within it. The processor was supposed to run at 620 MHz, but it only ran at 412 MHz. For the iPhone 3GS, introduced 2 years later, Apple decided for a Cortex A8-core Samsung CPU, signifying the beginnings of more performance-focused chip architecture. In 2013, Apple debuted the iPhone 5s, which was the first smartphone to ship with a 64-bit processor, the Apple A7 Cyclone. The decision moved Apple ahead of the rest of the mobile sector at the time. Apple's design philosophy has long focused on balancing power with efficiency. While Android chipmakers embraced 8 and 10-core designs, Apple has stuck with 6-core layouts since 2017, typically featuring 2 high-performance cores and 4 efficiency cores. Despite that, Apple routinely ranks at or near the top in both single-threaded and multi-core performance. 2024's iPhone 16 and iPhone 16 Pro continued that approach. The regular versions employ the A17 Bionic chip, constructed on a 3-nanometer technology, and scored over 8,100 in PC Watch's Geekbench 6 tests. The Pro models use the A18 Bionic, which scored scores above 8,500 and include core rates surpassing 4 GHz. For comparison, the iPhone 13 Pro Max from 2021 got roughly 5,700 in the same benchmark. That corresponds to a 50% improvement over 3 years. The performance increases gained by the different generations of iPhone from 2007 onwards is definitely enormous. However, there are drawbacks to the methods employed for testing. It's crucial to note that the values include projected conversions for the older iPhones, which predate contemporary standards. Apple may be gearing up for its biggest camera update ever with the next iPhone 17 Pro series. According to a leak supplied by Mac Rumors by an unidentified source, the upcoming Pro iPhones will offer numerous new camera capabilities. The insider claims to have knowledge of a commercial for the device, apparently filmed by the Slovenian production company Division Film. The studio even claims Apple as its client. However, McRumors adds the information has not been independently validated. One of the major changes supposedly coming to the iPhone 17 Pro is a new telephoto lens that offers up to 8x optical magnification. That's a big rise from the current 5x magnification on the iPhone 16 Pro Max and would provide customers more freedom when recording subjects from a distance. The new lens is reported to have continuous zoom capabilities across several focal lengths, something that would bring it closer to DSLR-style versatility. Apple is also believed to be developing a dedicated Pro camera app. The software would feature extensive photo and video tools and is likely to rival third-party apps like Halide and Filmic Pro. It's not yet clear whether the software will be restricted to the iPhone 17 Pro series or come to older handsets as well. More shockingly, Apple may be introducing a second camera control button, this time on the top edge of the phone. We'd be shocked if Apple truly examines this proposal, considering it has been said to be working toward a button-less phone design. Also, the existing camera button didn't earn very favorable ratings. While there's speculation of a brand new software, the insider also thinks Apple could instead provide a big update to its existing Final Cut camera app. Beyond camera enhancements, the source suggests the iPhone 17 Pro will arrive in a new copper-like finish and may sport a centered Apple logo on the back. Apple is anticipated to launch the iPhone 17 series in September. If even half of these camera speculations hold up, the Pro models will be a substantial advance over their predecessors. The end of 2024 brought along some fairly outlandish design rumors. The iPhone 17 could resemble a Pixel phone to an extent. there was this alleged iPhone 17 frame image that displayed a horizontal pixel-like camera island. This also made Google make a hilarious little clip on the matter. There's an X post from famed leaker Majin Buu that shows the vanilla iPhone 17 standing behind the purported iPhone 17 Air, the one on the left. The start of 2025 brought another chunk of design rumors. Apple is reportedly using a new splicing method for the iPhone 17, enabling a smoother transition between the back and the frame. This technique incorporates a slanted design where the back shell meets the main body, replacing the present sharper edges for a more seamless and ergonomic feel. The modification, though small, could boost both the phone's looks and its comfort in hand. Although the iPhone 17 lineup isn't due until September, several case makers are already allowing pre-orders based on leaked designs. Using CAD renders and 3D printing, these early cases reveal the phone's designs and camera placements, providing aficionados an opportunity to get a feel for the future models months ahead of launch. Apple's AI tools, first promised for release, are now postponed indefinitely due to readiness concerns, and the corporation has assumed full ownership for the marketing of unfinished functionality. While no imminent layoffs are expected, adjustments within the company are occurring, including shifts in leadership, to remedy the Apple intelligence difficulties. Apple has confirmed that the AI tools will now be available in a future update, with plans to only debut it when the product is perfected. The AI-revamped Siri, for example, is going to be really late. Robbie Walker, who leads Siri's team, has called the delays embarrassing and disappointing. This situation is reminiscent of when Tim Cook publicly apologized for the Apple Maps catastrophe in 2012. Meanwhile, Samsung is trying to beat Apple at their own game. For the Galaxy S26 Ultra, the Korean company is dreaming of putting a 2-nanometer Exynos 2600 chipset. If Apple doesn't manage to come up with a 2-nanometer chip for the iPhone 17 series, this will imply that Samsung, with its S26 Ultra, anticipated in the very beginning of 2026, will be the first phone with a 2-nanometer chip inside. The iPhone 17 will contain custom-designed Wi-Fi and Bluetooth processors, supporting the Wi-Fi 7 standard to improve performance, energy efficiency, and integration inside Apple's ecosystem. This step decreases dependency on third-party vendors like Broadcom. Additionally, Apple's vanilla iPhone 17 could feature the in-house C1 modem. ProMotion, previously unique to the Pro models, may now be expanded across the full iPhone 17 series. Rumors originally arose earlier this year, with respected source Ross Young predicting that all models in the iPhone 17 would feature a 120Hz refresh rate. Subsequent reports have reinforced this, suggesting that ProMotion and always-on displays will be available across all models. In late March, Bloomberg's Mark Gurman also stated the iPhone 17 is to get 120Hz refresh rate, aka ProMotion. This boosts the display's responsiveness, making scrolling seem fluid and animations appear smoother. The iPhone 17 is to inherit the super-thin bezels that debuted on the 2024 iPhones. That's thanks to the so-called border reduction structure technology to shrink the display bezels. The iPhone 16 Pro Max arrives with ultra-thin 1.15 millimeters bezels. Now that's impressive. Reducing the size of the top and side bezels is more or less easily feasible, but the bottom bezel undoubtedly prompted some Apple engineers to scratch their heads longer than what's commonly recognized. That's because the bottom bezel offers a hurdle due to heat-generating issues. The new border reduction structure technology seems to address this by allowing the bottom bezel to be as small as possible. It achieves this by rolling the copper wires at the bottom upward. Keep in mind that the data above could alter throughout time. Apple might remove the 128GB variant for the vanilla iPhone 17, and we could jump straight to 256GB. Also, there's another cause for the 128GB starting storage point to be finally got rid of in 2025. It's because of the power and storage-hungry AI. Apple may designate 12 gigs of RAM as the new baseline for all iPhone models. This growth in storage is because of the predicted on-device AI capabilities, which require large data, thereby rising storage demands. Similarly, AI processing is increasing the need for more RAM, necessitating this predicted improvement. The iPhone 15 and 15 Plus sported only 6 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of storage in their base variants. To help protect its phones from overheating, Apple is rumored to be working on a vapor cooling chamber, which would replace the typical heatsinks seen in Apple's existing phones. A shot showing off the vapor chamber has surfaced, adding to the belief that this feature will come to pass. It looks like only the Pro versions will provide vapor cooling. The larger iPhone 16 Pro design allows Apple to put a larger 3,582 mAh battery in that phone. It's unclear if Apple will have any room to expand battery size again with the iPhone 17 Pro, or simply rely on superior power efficiency to extend the battery life of its new phone. One thing that could change on the power front would be a rise to the iPhone 17 Pro's charging speeds from the 20-watt maximum that Apple's phones have been stuck at for years. A study note from February indicates charging speeds on the iPhone 17 range could increase to 35-watt. That's still a far cry from what phones like the S25 Ultra offer with their 45-watt wired charging speeds, but it's still a definite increase. Meanwhile, regulatory documents imply a Qi2 wireless charging upgrade providing greater speeds could be in place for the iPhone 17 series to benefit from. So, that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching.